Sexual energy is a cosmic evolutionary force. The buildup of excitation releases different plasmas, prana and radion. We must learn to direct this energy in ways that are beneficial to ourselves, to others, and to our environment. When we release the notions of sexuality strictly for reproductive purposes, then we can explore sexuality as a type of environmental interactiveness. For instance, in the Hindu tantric tradition, there are different kinds of Shakti energy. These correspond with different shades of sexual energy released, like the Parashakti energy, light and heat, or the Jnana Shakti energy, excitation through mind. The secret doctrine also mentioned these six primary forces of nature, Shakti, synthesized by the seventh point in the center. The Shakti is the feminine principle and also the principle of the matrix. Madame Blavatsky refers to the mythic forms or names that correspond to supernatural entities or principles also found in cosmic science. These six forms of Shakti represent the qualities of being, or powers that reside in, or are latent in, our being. These are the powers available to reach our true potential, Parashakti, power of light and heat, Jnana Shakti, power of mind, Ichta Shakti, power of will, the Kriya Shakti, power of thought, Kundalini Shakti, power of life force, and the Mantrika Shakti, power of sound. To these six Shaktis, we add magnetism, the cohesive power that unifies. When we consider these Shaktis as a spectrum of primal energy activation based on vibration, then we can recognize the focalizing power of pansexuality as a means of placing us in complete resonance with the cosmos as a whole. There is a seventh Shakti, Diva Prakriti, the light of the Logos. This is a supernal or etheric Shakti, the universal force that accomplishes different aspects of the ongoing functioning of nature. This also pertains to our own internal system and its functions, most namely, will and thought. In other words, all that is accomplished in the medium of life is actually brought about by channels of different flows of the different kinds of energies required by the spectrum of our thought and actions in an evolving continuum of cosmic evolution. We must explore new levels of comprehension of sexual energy in the new time. If we view Shakti as the supermental descent and Shiva as the spiritual ascent through matter that engenders this type of union, then the actual process of the closing of the cycles through two entities, male and female, is also part of a larger cosmic sexual function. The activated knowledge of the closing of the cycle, inclusive of the cosmic history chronicles and the law of time, is due to a mechanism known as terma and terton. There are two aspects to this. The terma represents a descent of a type of Shakti energy, which is the terma of Pakalvotan, and the terton represents the aspiration to discover the terma or the treasure. For this to be fully facilitated, there is an actual human engagement of two avataric forces or principles. The Shiva is symbolized by the closer of the cycle, the ascending blue triangle, and the Shakti is symbolized by the regenerator of the cycle, the red descending triangle. They come together and form a six-pointed star in a common field. The Ouroboric circle around them is cosmic history. When the union is complete, then the noogenesis occurs and ignites the planetary kundalini that makes the law of sex become a conscious operating factor in human evolution. The energy is harnessed and focalized through the sex organs. From a higher level, this produces whole other internal imaginal experiences and sensations. One of the finest of these can be represented by the lotus and the vajra. The mantra Om Mani Padme Hum can be translated as O hail the jewel in the flower of the lotus. The jewel is the vajra scepter, which represents the male element, and the lotus the female element. When these are brought together and focused at the heart center, then we have a channeling of the sexual energy through an imaginal emblem that radiates out in fields of compassion, sending bliss waves to all beings. These are waves of charged energy that pacify and calm the environment and creatively engage it at subliminal levels. By 2012 and beyond, we will become much more sexually integrated beings, and our sexuality will be primarily self-generating and directed toward ourselves in ever more evolved states. Sexuality will be liberated altogether from procreation, and instead will become the principal medium of spiritual evolution. In our sexual cultivation, we will become brilliant, radiant energy beings, and at the same time, we will choose, according to twin soul affinities, to integrate further with another being to start a new psychosexual chain reaction. This is our future waiting to be explored.